Once we realized that we were going to have to close, it was so stressful that you didn't really have much time to think. It was like you're in this environment where you're focused on closing this property, this, you know, 6 million square foot property that isn't built to be closed. It's never been closed before. For the first time in 23 and a half years, you know, we temporarily closed our building. You go from this property that's usually full of people. You think about New Year's Eve at Mohegan Sun with the shops concourse and just how full it is. And then, you know, that Tuesday night where we closed, there's no one and it's quiet. And you just hear the waterfall and you hear the wolves and you don't hear any slot machines and there's no one playing table games and there's no one in the arena. And you're one of 50 people that's here and you're walking around. And I think at that point, you know, sadness. I think, you know, the emotion of just being really, really sad that our property was closed. We're gonna turn our focus to helping, you know, our team members and our local community and doing everything we can to support everyone that's, you know, just important to our business. You know, the first thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna be donating a bunch of food to our team members. So we have all this food, you know, with our closure that is in our freezers and our refrigerators that's gonna go bad.
Today we're going to be giving away masks to the local community. People will be driving up to the Indian Summer Garage. We set up a path through public safety and transportation. Myself got together.
So while we're closed, I see that some of the back of house castmates are sending at home videos. You have Erica walking on the beach. You have Andre eating an obscene amount of food. So it's interesting to see the things that, you know, the castmates, the team members are going through while they're at home.
You can hear those mixed bunch of nuts in my family. Oops, they could hear me.
I'm missing everyone terribly. I am far too social for all of this social distancing.
Goose and I are going on a walk.
I always wanted to start a podcast, and I've been on a few, and they've gone well, and I'm like, I'm into it. You know, they're harder than it seems, so I've been dabbling with that. I've been working with some people on trying to get that up and going.
And here we go, slow riding.
So we've been focusing on the reopening now, you know, for weeks. And as we're going through this, you just find that there's so much to do. You know, to reopen, to close a property, you think that there's a lot, but now you have to reopen the property and you have to rethink the operation totally. Because, you know, you have to create this safe environment for our team members and our guests. And there's just so many things to evaluate and to look at, so much work that needs to get done, so much thinking, things that we didn't think of that people are bringing to our attention. I mean, it's like there's so many nooks and crannies to keeping, to opening Mohegan Sun and then keeping everyone that visits Mohegan Sun safe. And I'm really lucky that I just have just a tremendous team that kind of took each of their areas and evaluated it and created a comprehensive plan.
So I'm the director of hotel operations. My responsibilities include everything lobby level. So hotel check-in, concierge, the bellman, as well as the pool. So we are about a week out now. This is the first day that I actually have one of my team members back with me. So that's super exciting. So I have Melissa here with me. She's one of my managers. We're going to go through, I'm going to kind of go over all the things that I've been working on as far as the sanitation procedures. First and foremost, plexi has been installed across all areas. So that includes ascend desk, bell desk, concierge. So all of our areas have that as a safety between the team members and the guests.
On the other side, you're also gonna see hand sanitizer. We've kind of stationed at every other station. We're really gonna encourage the guests as they step up to sanitize, just to kind of keep that safety measure going.
Since we were closed, the keys have been out. We have about 90,000 of them to actually clean, so it's gonna take a minute. So we're gonna start with that.
A lot of things that popped up from the plexiglass in the casino shop that it's just installed hundreds and hundreds of pieces of plexiglass, as you all see throughout the property, both on table games and anywhere there was a face-to-face interaction with a guest, to the carpenter shop working on our sanitary wipes. Over 200 of those dispensers had to be made, and they did it all with ease. I want to give a shout out to the team members and thank them from the bottom of my heart, because they were true professionals in every sense of that term.
You know, our team gets 100 things done in one day, and there feels like there's 5 million more things to do over the course of the next 2 days, but we're not gonna sleep. I know, you know, we have with Dan and with Stokely and with our leadership team, we're not gonna sleep till we get this place reopened. And I'm thinking about all the things I need to do, but I'm also thinking about, you know, just seeing that first customer, that first guest walk back into our property and how exciting that's gonna be.